से आप नहीं पढ़ोगी तो ये भी कलाम है, दैट वुड बी इनजस्टिस। यहाँ तो सही आ रही है ना हैंडराइटिंग, दैट्स इंप्रूव्ड। आपस जैसे वहां लिखना है आप ट्राई करो वैसे लिखने की, दैट विल सेव यू, सो यू डोंट हैव टू बी एनी एक्सपर्ट्स एनीथिंग। So, why are we talking about this thing? We talked about virtue ethics, right?
Yes, sir.
We talked about, partly about conduct ethics, we did this part, teleological ethics, utilitarianism, hedonism and egoism. So, we are left with deontological ethics and rights-based, ethics. So, we'll talk about these things today. What is deontological ethics and what is rights? So let's come to this part. Now when we are done with teleological ethics, deontological ethics. So basically it's a part of conduct ethics. And in case of teleological ethics, I told you that over there the focus or emphasis is on the ends. So means become very important over here. Of course, ends have their own significance. Okay, but over here we cannot say that means are not important. For example, under this teleological ethics, it could justify the things I told you yesterday of robbing a bank or speaking lies. ethics would denounce it as unethical. For example, these things. Okay, so it is the kind of premise to deontological ethics. So we'll talk about this thing in very detail. Actually, the major propounder of the school of thought remains the German philosopher. Have you heard this name ever?
Yes, sir.
Immanuel Kant.
Yes.
He was basically an 18th century German philosopher. So he is the major proponent of the school of thought, or the school of the ethics. He was a person who wasn't formally educated. He had never been to school or college or university. He was a very poor person, okay, and had not resources at his disposal. So he would roam around here and there and here and there, and it was the, you know, experiences of life which eventually made him and sculpted this person out of him, out of that boy. He was always this particular about his timing. He was very punctual. So wo daily basis pe kuch kaam kiya karta tha, and so to do those works he would pass through streets. जैसे गलियों रास्तों से गुजरता था, एंड ही वाज सो पंक्चुअल कि नाउ द पीपल हु यूज्ड टू बी देयर ऑन दोस स्ट्रीट्स दे वुड नो कि इमैनुअल कांट वुड पास थ्रू दिस प्लेस, एंड समटाइम्स इफ दे फील लाइक कि वो घड़ी के हिसाब से आगे पीछे आ रहा है, मतलब यूजुअली ही वुड कम एट 8, नाउ टुडे इज कमिंग एट 8:15 या 7:45 तक, तो वो नहीं समझते थे कि वो जल्दी आ रहे हैं या बाद में आ रहे हैं. दे वुड चेंज द टाइमिंग ऑफ देयर वॉचेस दैट ही इज सो रेगुलर दैट ही वुड बी देयर ऑन टाइम. हमसे हमारी घड़ी में कुछ इश्यू हुआ होगा, ठीक है. एंड दिस इज वेरी पॉपुलर अबाउट इमैनुअल कांट. तो उन्हीं का मतलब जो मेजर कंट्रीब्यूशन है डियोंटोलॉजिकल एथिक्स में, दैट्स अ कांट. तो इन्हीं की हम थ्योरी देखते हैं एक्चुअली व्हाट ही हैज टू से. The morality of an action can be judged by the inner motto of a person, not the external influences. His ethical theory is based on the premise of goodwill, that is the moral sense of duty or obligation. Duty must be done out of pure reverence for moral law. So what does all this mean? I'll try to explain that in the next few minutes. See, prior to this, we had ethical theories like ये चीज हमने पढ़ी egoism, hedonism, right? तो इसके हिसाब से वो चीज जायज है जिससे मैक्सिमम लोगों का मैक्सिमम फायदा होगा, मैक्सिमम गुड टू मैक्सिमम पीपल. अगर ऐसा कोई एंड आपको मिल रहा है, यूटिलिटेरियनिज्म वुड टेल यू दैट गो फॉर इट, ओके, एंड दैट एक्शन वुड बी एथिकल एज पर दिस एंड दिस इगोइज्म. इफ एनी एक्शन इज यू नो मैक्सिमाइजिंग योर सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट, गो फॉर इट. मैक्सिमम प्लेजर, गो फॉर इट. दिस इज नॉट कंसर्न्ड अबाउट द एंड्स, ठीक है. Yeah, there would be, you know, the end would be in the mind, but the emphasis is not there. The morality of action can be judged by this inner motto, not external influence. Yeah, aapko samjhane ke liye main aise bataunga ki morality of an action depends upon jisko hum niyat kehte hain, ki insaan ki wo kis niyat se koi kaam karta hai, theek hai. As per Kant, even if you do something good, ठीक है, बट कुछ सोच के किया होगा, मतलब मे बी मैक्सिमाइजिंग योर ओन सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट और समथिंग लाइक दैट, दैट इज नॉट मॉरल थिंग. आई विल गिव एन एग्जांपल. सी फॉर एग्जांपल, यू आर अ ग्रुप ऑफ, यू आर न्यू इन द क्लास, व्हाट्स योर नेम?
खदीजा.
खदीजा, ओके, गुड. ओके, सपोज शी हैज कम फॉर फर्स्ट टाइम, राइट? तो कल ये क्लास में नहीं थी, राइट? एंड शी मिस्ड यस्टरडेज क्लास, ओके. And obviously she missed the content, she doesn't have the notes. Now suppose this girl who is sitting next to her, so she may give her notes of yesterday's class. ये तो ये अच्छा काम है ना? She is helping her, she is giving her notes, okay? तो इस mindset के साथ देती है that अगर मैं इनको नोट दे दूं दैट शी विल फील लाइक दैट शी इज अ गुड पर्सन. मे बी किसी के दिमाग में ये चल रहा हो कि किसी की हेल्प करोगे तो अगला सामने वाला बंदा समझेगा कि अच्छा आदमी है, ठीक है. मे बी दिस इज इन हर माइंड, तो इस चीज के तहत वो इनकी हेल्प कर रही है, ठीक है. तो ये इनकी नीयत ये है, इस सोच के तहत शी इज गिविंग हर द नोट्स. काम तो अच्छा ही हो रहा है, सोच चाहे अंदर क्या भी हो, बट एज पर कांट दिस इज इमोरल. यूटिलिटेरियनिज्म एंड अदर थियरीज में जस्ट फेयर बिकॉज द एंड्स आर बीइंग सर्वड हियर, ठीक है. अब ओके, अब फिर से इनके दिमाग में शायद ये सोच आ रही है दैट शी हैज सम काइंड ऑफ पिटी फॉर हर, कितने सारे क्लासेस मिस कर दिए, पता नहीं क्या होगा क्या नहीं होगा, सो आई शुड बी हेल्पिंग हर, ठीक है. एनीवे, हियर अगेन शी गिव्स हर द नोट्स, बट मेंटालिटी इज दिस, एज पर काउंट दिस इज इमोरल अगेन. तो देन व्हाट इज मोरल? शी शुड गिव हर द नोट्स ऑफ कोर्स, बट ये सोच के दैट इट इज हर मॉरल सेंस ऑफ ड्यूटी, इसके तहत देना है, तब जाके वो चीज मॉरल है, ठीक है. दैट इज व्हाई द फोकस इन केस ऑफ कांटियन एथिक्स इज ऑन द इनर मोटिव. समटाइम्स आप किसी अच्छी नीयत से कोई काम करते हो, ठीक है, उसका मे बी देयर इज अ डिजास्टर्स इंपैक्ट. फॉर एग्जांपल, यू एक्चुअली गो टू हेल्प आउट समबडी, but in the meanwhile there is some sort of accident and a person loses lives, but you have to see here, we, you know, intend to see what was the inner motive of the person, theek hai, and on that basis we say whether any action is moral or immoral, whether it is ethical or unethical, theek hai. On contrary, there could be someone, a philanthropist, aise wo, he is helping the poor, he is providing funds to, you know, augment education and alleviate poverty, to is cheez ke liye wo paise de raha hai, so naturally we would say this is a good work, something good. But अगर उनके दिमाग में ये चल रहा होगा that this is something that would help me in building my own image, ठीक है, या लोगों को लगेगा वो बहुत बड़ा मसीहा है, इस सोच के साथ अगर वो देगा तो that is immoral as per Kant. ठीक है. सो दैट इज वेर ही लेज द एम्फेसिस ऑन द इनर मोटिव. हिज एथिकल थियरी इज बेस्ड ऑन द प्रमिस ऑफ गुडविल. ये वो चीज है कि इस चीज के तहत आपको हेल्प करनी है. इट इज द मॉरल सेंस ऑफ ऑब्लिगेशन और ड्यूटी. ठीक है. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द प्रमिस ऑफ गुडविल. नो सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट, नो मैक्सिमाइजिंग प्लेजर. ठीक है. You have to do any kind of duty because it, you know, your, that should be your moral sense of obligation or duty. And duty must be done out of pure reverence for moral law, not for any self-interest. Yeah, you know, I'll be a good person in his eyes later on. So that should not be the kind of, you know, it should not be pursued. So this is one thing.
एग्जांपल ऑफ सलमान खान ब्रांड बीइंग ह्यूमन सर, वो फिलैंथ्रोपी करता है कि उसका जो भी आएगा ही गिवन.
इसका ये लिमिटेशन आई विल टेल यू लेटर ऑन, यू नो, व्हेन दिस वाज आई वाज अबाउट टू टॉक अबाउट इट इन द एंड, कि हमें किसी के नियत के बारे में पता नहीं चल सकता. यू कैन हेल्प मी, आई डोंट नो आपने किस मोटिव के तहत मुझे हेल्प किया. सो दैट इज आल्सो अ लिमिटेशन ऑफ दिस कांटियन एथिक्स. सो ये कहता है कि दैट the inner motive should be driven by this this duty to the moral laws or moral principles, and somebody can proclaim that I am knowing it under this thing, but hum wo jaan nahi payenge ki inhone inhe note diya, wo isliye diya, and we cannot check that. So I don't know ki Salman Khan charity karta hai, but we should appreciate it. If he is helping out somebody, अब क्या चीज is the, you know, which he talked about कि आपको ये चीज करनी चाहिए. It should be a moral duty to certain things, ठीक है. अब what would be that moral duty, आपको क्या करना चाहिए क्या नहीं करना चाहिए. He came up with a concept called categorical imperative. इससे हम को शायद it will help us in finding out that what we need to do, what's our moral duty, what we are, you know, obligated or supposed to do. So इस चीज से हमें वो पता चलेगा. But before explaining this, he himself came up with a concept that is called as hypothetical imperative. इसकी बात करते हैं. What I ought to do if certain conditions hold, that would also mean specific end. Okay. For example, आपको UPSC pass करना है. This is your end, right? This is the goal. And here in hypothetical imperative, आपको ये चीजें करनी हैं. For example, here in the series revision and NCERTs. ठीक है, you have a specific goal in your mind, and there are few things what you need to do to meet this specific goal. तो ये चीज़ आप तभी करोगे जब this is very well defined for you. अगर ये आपके सामने goal ही नहीं होता, there was no need to do this. समझ गए? तो इन चीजों के करने की कोई जरूरत ही नहीं थी अगर आपके पास ये गोल नहीं होता. सो दे अराइज बिकॉज यू हैव दिस थिंग इन माइंड. ठीक है, अब इसी को हम कैटेगोरिकल, दिस इज हाइपोथेटिकल इंपेरेटिव। What we ought to do unconditionally, ये हम चीजें कर रहे थे just to meet this thing, okay? Now हमें कुछ चीजें ऐसी भी है wherein we would not have any specific goal in our mind, nevertheless we need to do that. For example, being courageous, आपका चाहे goal कुछ भी हो, कहां जा रहे हो, कुछ भी कर रहे हो, यू शुड मैनिफेस्ट दिस, यू शुड डू दैट। स्पीकिंग ट्रूथ, ठीक है, नॉट इंडल्जिंग इन वायलेंस, एंड देयर इज अ big list of the things I need to do unconditionally, and that would fall into the categorical imperative. And categorical imperative is something that tells you the moral sense of duty. Have I told you, for example, these are the few things which come under categorical. That means you need to do them unconditionally. So then, what would be the, you know, other things which would fall in here? Or how do we test that something comes in it or doesn't come in it? So Kant said that we have to do two kinds of tests for everything. If we have any categories to put in it, then we need to do include anything categorical in under this categorical imperative to test us for anything need to be done. You know, sadly, tests, for example, wisdom, courage, and all those kind of things, they will fall in here. So then automatically wo yahan pe aa jayenge, and you need to do them anyway, chahe kuch bhi ho, whatever your goal is. To basically to test us. Would flow like this. You take anything, you do two tests, qualifies, forms categorical imperative, and then there is moral sense of duty that ye aapko fir karna padega, chahe whatever is the situation. So in short, you keep this thing in your mind that when it comes to deontological ethics, the means assume huge significance. And in case of teleological ethics, the ends remain very important. Humanities test humans should be treated as end in themselves, not a means to something. He said that duty is superior to happiness. For example, I told you कि under utilitarianism हमें बस happiness चाहिए थी. वो कहाँ से आए क्या? It doesn't matter. And with respect to other schools of ethics, they would talk about maximizing happiness. But here it's about the duty. It would not allow you to lie. ठीक है. It would not allow you to do anything. Is this clear? Deontological, more about means. It's about inner motive. It's about the goodwill thing. Categorical imperative. So these are few terms you have to remember as far as this is concerned. So this is Gandhian ethics bhi aata hai because he was a person who only emphasized on means. He would not advocate for violence so as to achieve the independence of India. So he was keen. Resorting to very moral means of non-violence and this satya and ahimsa. So that would also come under deontological ethics, but we will talk about Indian moral philosophers will talk about Gandhian ethics separately. Okay. So, iske baad we'll talk about later school, horizons increasing, something is seen as ethical if it is in consonance with the rights of others, infringement of rights of others would be seen as unethical. Done? Is clear? So then I'll explain. So, in case of contemporary societies in most of the countries, we have democracies. We have countries run by the constitutions, we have countries run by the law. And those constitutions, they endow or bestow citizens with different kinds of rights. Okay? You as a citizen of India, there is a good quantum of rights that has been provided to you by the constitution of India. When you have equality, you would know about fundamental rights. Okay, you would know about statutory rights, that would be legal rights. So there's a, you know, entire this bouquet of rights which have been given to these people. So rights-based approach mein ye hai ki har kisi citizen ke apne rights hai, aapke apne rights hai, mere apne rights hai. So how I determine the morality of any action is that as long as my action is in consonance with rights of this person, that would be considered as moral or ethical. Okay? And in case I ever infringe into the rights of this person, that would be seen as unethical, action. For example, there would be certain rights provided to the tribal people under Forest Rights Act of 2006, wherein a consent is needed from the Gram Sabha to go ahead with any developmental project. Okay? This is the right provided to the people by the law of the country. But suppose if there is a strong corporate group and they bypass it, this test, okay? And over there they are doing whatever they want to do and they are bypassing this law, this Gram Sabha consent, okay? So at that point of time they are infringing into the rights of the people. So if we judge that action, we can say that it accounts to infringement of the rights, so it's an unethical thing. Or for that matter, the piracy thing I told you, or speaking a lie, okay? For example, here again you are violating the rights of a person. For example, some person has a right to knowledge, okay? As of now, that is not in the books, but as per rights-based approach, we can say that that is immoral act, because you are not providing or giving the information to any person. Jo unke right to knowledge hona chahiye tha, you are not providing the same. So that again is an immoral act. Same way, for example, piracy of movies, okay? So you are writing someone's right to property. That again is a right provided to him by the constitution, by the law. But wo aap kar rahe ho, violate, okay? So jahan jahan pe bhi kisi ko koi right mila hua hai, usko violate kar rahe ho, to us cheez ko hum bol sakte hai that it is not ethical, it's not moral. So on that basis, yahan pe ethics and morality is determined, okay? So, to give you an idea, a human is born with certain rights, and those are called natural rights, okay? And these are the rights which nobody can take away. For example, in case of fundamental rights, agar state chahe to they can take away a fundamental right, okay? So, aapne padha hoga, but it has to be something that doesn't go against the basic structure of the constitution. Khair, they can take it away, but these, just because you happen to be humans, on that account you enjoy certain rights and nobody can take these away from you. Right to life, liberty, property. Okay, this is the first set of rights which was there from the beginning, which scholars would talk about in the era of Renaissance and even during the ancient times. Inki baat hoti thi. So fir thoda time jaise evolve hota gaya, there is more evolution in case of rights, and now we say that our society is called a rights-based society, because all the segments of the people, sections of the society, they enjoy different rights. For example, the first thing was civil and political rights. Okay, the first generation, this was something that was iske liye struggle kiya gaya tha through American Revolution ya French Revolution. So these things aim to get first generation rights. For example, right to vote. Theek hai? So those are the civil and political rights jo inhone tab demand ki thi. And jab ye milne laga logon ko, then people went ahead. They rose up the hierarchy and they started demanding for second generation rights, which are social rights. For example, this was something in the American Civil War. So people started demanding. When did this happen? You have any idea about American Civil War? Anything idea about American Revolution?
सर इसमें 13 ब्रिटिश जो कॉलोनीज थी यहाँ पे तो उनके ऊपर जो टैक्स था वो बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ा दिया गया था जो यहाँ से ट्रेड होता और ट्रेड को भी बंद कर देते थे कई जगह क्योंकि वो बोलते थे कि अमेरिकन कॉलोनी है कुछ कंट्री के साथ उनको सैंक्शन लगा दिए गए तो जिससे वो परेशान हो उन्होंने अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशन किया।
ओके आप पढ़ोगे आगे सो दीज आर इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक्स इन देमसेल्व्स तो आप अलग से पढ़ लीजिएगा तो फॉर दैट मैटर फॉर एग्जांपल इन केस ऑफ अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशंस द देयर वाज द एम वाज टू गेट द सिविल लाइन द पॉलिटिकल राइट्स फिर उसके बाद व्हेन अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशन हैपेंड इट टर्न्ड आउट टू बी अ रिपब्लिकन डेमोक्रेसी ओके बट देयर वर सर्टेन इश्यूज बिटवीन ब्लैक्स एंड वाइट्स ओके एंड एज अ रिजल्ट वी हैड दिस ऑफ कोर्स दिस व्हाट्स कॉल्ड एज अमेरिकन सिविल वॉर ठीक है व्हेयर इन द एम वाज टू अबॉलिश द स्लेवरी इन केस ऑफ यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ America at the time of Lincoln, he was the president at that point of time. So, yahan pe there was social rights, right to equality, there should not be discrimination on this ground or that ground. So, that is second generation rights. And the third generation rights is the cultural rights. Culture is basically right, you have a way of your life, okay? So, nobody should come in and tell you that you should live this way or that way, okay? Nobody should coerce you or force you. For example, yahan pe aaj kal hum demand kar rahe hain for LGBT rights. Because it's their way of life and we should not tell somebody else that you should give up on this thing and you should be rather doing this thing, okay? And there is fourth generation rights wherein you have rights pertaining to environment, okay? That it is the responsibility of the state to provide a good environment, pollution free. And the rights pertaining to the internet, etc. So, nine things are coming. And over a period of time, it will be like, fifth gen, sixth gen, this would evolve over a period of time, this is the society evolve hoti ja rahi hai, because this was roughly in 18th century, jab humne first generation demand, matlab start ke demand karna hai, and over a period of 2-3 centuries or 4 centuries, we have reached here. So over a period of time, these demands could increase over a period of time. So aap mujhe bataiye, abhi tak hamara constitution kis generation tak ke rights hame provide karta hai? Any idea? Okay. पार्टली हमने कुछ कर लिया इसमें कुछ चीजें बची हैं तो वो टॉक अबाउट दैट ओके
सर द आंसर टू योर क्वेश्चन
नहीं 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 ये पॉलिटी वाले सर से पूछ लेना
सर
नहीं यू हैव टू सी दिस आर्टिकल 21 जो है इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन का तो दिस इज आल्सो एवर इंक्रीजिंग बिकॉज़ ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम The Supreme Court has been continuously saying that they keep on adding rights to it. Rights to good night's sleep, right to marriage, and initially they were not there. It just says right to life and liberty. So Supreme Court is making things add karta ja raha hai. So they have tried to bring it, you know, in consonance with the contemporary society. Jo aaj society demand karti hai. For example, aajkal ki society mein LGBT rights bhi, they should be there, but as of now, wo hum प्रोवाइड नहीं कर पा रहे हैं सो पार्टली देर आर सम थिंग्स ऑफ थर्ड जनरेशन विच आर बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड विद द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बट नॉट ऑल द राइट्स ओके एंड इवन देर इज सम सॉर्ट ऑफ यू नो एफर्ट्स बाय द लॉ मेकर्स और बाय द जुडिशरी टू इवन प्रोवाइड अस विद सर्टेन राइट्स विच आर इन फोर्थ जनरेशन बट ऐसा अभी एक्चुअली कुछ सीन नहीं है फॉर एग्जाम्पल स्टेट कैन ईजिली स्नैप द इंटरनेट Okay, ठीक है. And with respect to environment, you cannot actually go and sue फॉर एग्जाम्पल भोपाल में एयर क्वालिटी बहुत खराब है, तो इस पे आप कोर्ट में जाके गवर्नमेंट को सू भी नहीं कर सकते, ठीक है? दैट इज व्हाट हैपेंस इन केस ऑफ फंडामेंटल राइट्स वेयर दे आर जस्टिसेबल, यू कैन गो टू कोर्ट इन केस दोस राइट्स आर नॉट फुलफिल्ड. सो पार्टली इट इज समवेयर अप टू सेकंड जनरेशन, फर्स्ट जनरेशन डन, ठीक है, सेकंड जनरेशन डन, थर्ड में कुछ कुछ चीजें भी प्रोवाइड हुई है, नॉट द एंटायर, बट एट द सेम टाइम हम उस पे ही नहीं टिके हुए हैं. वी आर ट्राइंग एट अवर लेवल की द फोर्थ जनरेशन की भी राइट्स जो है, at least there is some sort of debate and the state is at least trying, and even the very you know judiciary is very proactive about that, so that we should be able to provide the fourth generation rights also to the citizens of India. Aur jo hum provide abhi nahi kar paye hue in form of fundamental rights, at least we have DPSP for that, okay, directive principles of state policy. They are not justiciable again, but at least that is a vision kind of for the government and the lawmakers, that you should make laws in this direction so as to serve the people. For example, usme aise it is not a fundamental right to have a livelihood, yeah, it depends upon the government to provide the livelihood, but it is there in the DPSP, and it was under the aegis of DPSP that MG Narendra was brought in, so as to provide some sort of livelihood wherein state gives you all those kind of things. So abhi state shayad cannot afford to give you every right, but again then we have DPSP, so efforts are there so as to give maximum rights to the people. And yahan pe ye hai, we are always concerned about our rights, not about duties. Hum tax chori karte hain, bijli band nahi karte, and all those kind of things, we are ready to flout the rules and jump traffic signals. So those are issues, we have to be good citizens, take care of all the things, okay? So he actually is not a Western moral thinker, but we'll have to talk about him. Kabhi naam suna hai inka? Confucius or Confucianism is a sort of religion that is practiced by people. क्या नहीं सुना है तो ज़्यादा दिमाग मत ख़राब कीजिए. Most celebrated and popular and celebrated Chinese philosopher. Present. So this is some people, they practice it as a religion too. And he didn't present himself as a prophet, but he actually worked tirelessly for the benefit of humanity, and he remains very popular Chinese philosopher. talk about this. Fine. So as I yesterday I was talking about the virtue ethics, okay? And I gave you I told you that in case of virtue ethics, we actually see the virtues of the character of a person, and on the basis of that we see whether he's an ethical or not. And that was a school of ethics that was propounded by the ancient Greek philosophers. But at the same time, I also told you that the religious morality that roughly also falls in virtue ethics. So, kisi bhi religion ki ho, and whatever he also advocated that falls in the realm of domain of virtue ethics again, because he laid emphasis on the virtues. And a few he emphasized on good character and gave importance to virtues like honesty, austerity, piousness, of a person's spirituality, and few more these virtues. तो उन्होंने कहा कि ये चीजें एक इंसान में होनी चाहिए टू बी अ गुड कैरेक्टर इंडिविजुअल. ठीक है, एक अच्छा इंसान होने के लिए. और वही और जब आप इफ यू आर अ गुड ह्यूमन बीइंग ऑब्वियसली यू वुड बी एन एथिकल मॉरल पर्सन. फिर जब आप कोई काम करोगे यू वुड बी एथिकल पर्सन. बट देन हाउ डू यू एक्चुअली इनकल्केट दीज थिंग्स इन यू इन पीपल. ये जो सारी चीजें हैं, सो वे ऑफ इनकल्केटिंग वर्चुअस इन पीपल, तो ही गेव अस फ्यू ways. That number one is through self-cultivation. That at your own level you have to realize that this is a set of virtues and these characterize a good character. Okay? And as such you have to try to inculcate those values in you. That means it would depend on you actually for the purpose of self-cultivation. Okay? You have to see different kinds of values which are good and then try to cultivate them in you. By emulating moral exemplars, that means by copying the people who already have a good character, whose conduct is good, so who kind of have set an example for a good character, you simply copy those people. And then he goes on to say and says that you have to make decisions based on judgment, not based on rules. That means you have to think at your own level while making a decision. You don't have to fall for the rules, because he said that rules are something which are very monotonous. Rules though are actually made to increase efficiency. For example, there are so many rules by the government, aapko ye karna hai, ye nahi karna hai, etc. Different rules, and they are made so as to actually increase convenience, increase efficiency, या जो भी डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ इश्यूज पॉसिबली कुड बी देयर इन द इफेक्टिव इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट पॉलिसीज, स्कीम्स, लॉज एटसेट्रा, उनमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होनी चाहिए. दैट इज व्हाई वी हैव रूल्स. बट समटाइम्स व्हाट वी बिकम, द सोसाइटी बिकम्स अ होस्टेज टू दीज रूल्स. हमें ये पता है कि ये इतने बजे पंचिंग करना है, फिर ये करना है, ये करना है, ये करना है, मतलब दिस इज अ प्रोसीजर फॉर द डे, दिस इज डिक्टेटेड टू अस बाय द रूल्स. एंड इन द मीनवाइल वी काइंड ऑफ बिकम मशीन्स. And we give in to these rules, we stop thinking on our own. And that's why that he says that you have to stick with judgment. And not, you don't have to be a slave of rules. That whatever rules say that you have to do that everything, at the same time you have to keep your brain open, mind open, heart open, and you have to think simultaneously. So as to make decisions, and that would, they would be rather more ethical decisions. If you every time you think and base your judgments on the basis of this, judgments rather than on rules. And this was something that was taken forward by Max Weber. And he says ki usne, in the society he lived in, he could see that there are rules for everything. He talked something about bureaucracy, about rationalization. And in case of bureaucracy, there is something called a rationalization, कि सब कुछ rule के हिसाब से चीजें होती हैं, ठीक है? And he was like that कि अब ये है that people are getting alienated from themselves because they have become hostage to these rules, and this is something this has led to disenchantment in the society. For example, he gives या उसको अगर हम later on there was one more thinker, he was called Ritzer. उसमें he equated it with this a chain of McDonald's, the restaurant chain, and how things are prepared. Everything happens as a rule. It is fine to do those things over there because that increases efficiency. But if you tend to behave like that in your real life, you turn out to be a machine, an emotionless fellow. Okay, and that is very problematic. So you, in some time, you actually feel alienated. you lose your own self in the process of following rules. So that was also the concept that इन्होंने बहुत पहले कहा था, and then there has been a development to this thought that we should not give in to rules. Well, rules are important, then, but at the same time we should be thinking fellows also. So this was his ethical thought, which he talked about. Basically a 17th century English philosopher. So this name is very famous. He is being quoted regularly by people. He is a very important name in case of political science. So we'll talk about Hobbes, okay? He lived roughly in 17th century, you can see that. At that point of time, Europe was caught into different wars. There was violence, there was bloodshed, there was carnage, and all those things, all the time. He could see that, he could witness that himself. And wo dekhte dekhte, he came to a conclusion that there are a lot many thinkers who would say that man by nature is good, and he is a thinker. He says that man by nature is very selfish. He is an evil person by nature, because that was in certain contexts at that point of time. He saw that there was bloodshed and people would enjoy doing that all the time. Okay, and this was his conclusion that man by nature is an evil person. Okay, so फिर इन्होंने क्या किया? He tried to go back to the origins of humanity. He went back to state of nature. Okay, state of nature is like when you know, people came together initially when there was no government. Imagine the first kind of society when people would form social groups, come together and live together. तो उस टाइम पे क्या होता था? एंड ही वाज लाइक, ही सेड दिस इज अ वेरी फेमस स्टेटमेंट, तो इसे बार बार इस लाइन को कोट किया जाता है बाय सो मेनी पीपल. दिस इज वेरी फेमस लाइन. Life in state of nature is poor, solitary, nasty and brute. Okay, so I'll explain. So iska kya matlab hai? So he went back here to the state of nature, the initial society, and he could think and he could realize that at that point of time life was like this only. Theek hai, that there was a lot of violence going on. ठीक है, लिख लीजिए. Poor, solitary, nasty and brute. Done? Okay. तो he went back to the state of nature and he was kind of disillusioned with that concept and he was like कि तब people had all the liberty. ठीक है, जब initial society थी, there was no controlling agency, so people could do whatever they would like, right? तो दिन भर कोई काम करके he would gather some food, शाम में कोई भी आके he would enter his premises and would steal away the food. There was no accountability. There could be a cold-blooded murder on road and nobody would tell you anything. ठीक है? So that is why he used these terms, poor, solitary, nasty and rude. ठीक है? That is how life was over there. Then he came back to the society he lived in the 17th century, English society, and he tried to trace the origin. Upstate, मतलब गवर्नमेंट का जो अभी गवर्नमेंट उन्हें रेगुलेट कर रही थी, that how did it come into being, ये जो स्टेट है, जो गवर्नमेंट है, for example, even we have a government. Even at that point of time, whatever the state was, whether it may not have been democracy at that point of time, it was authoritarianism or monarchy, ठीक है? But the state was there, and he came to this point that how did it came into being, ठीक है? And to explain that concept, this is his most famous concept, जिससे उसने explain किया, that is called as social contract. Maybe इसके बारे में you may have heard somewhere because again this is a very popular concept. So इससे उन्होंने explain करने की कोशिश की that how state came into being or the government came into being. तो he was like he explained it this way कि instead of nature life was like this, there was violence, there was bloodshed, there was no regard for rights, okay? So, ये सब होने लगा, and the members of the society, they began to feel that their life is not safe. They could be killed by any person at any point of time. So, there was no regard to any law, any right or anything, ठीक है? तो फिर लोगों ने क्या किया, society came together, the entire society, and they decided to form some kind of agency. Which would regulate the behavior and conduct of the individual members in the society. ठीक है? So what would happen in this case that all the members of the society they would give or sacrifice a part of their liberty. ठीक है? And they would give that power to a certain agency which was called a state later on. ठीक है? And at the same time अब मैं थोड़ा अपनी तरफ से sacrifice कर रहा हूँ. I'm giving you the power to regulate me and other people. ठीक है? But at the same time, the onus is on you that you have to safeguard my life, my property, my liberty, and my other rights. ठीक है? So मैं चीज sacrifice करके आपको power दे रहा हूँ, but आपकी duty बनती है कि you will save my life and other things. So there was this contract between the society and the state. ठीक है? And that is how the state came into existence. This is what Hobbes tells us. ठीक है? And because people who feel unsafe, ठीक है? And they needed someone to protect them. ठीक है? In the meanwhile, they also compromised on their own liberty because तब तक तो बिल्कुल liberty was absolute. For example, today we have government and government has so many rights on you. They can tell you that you have to do this thing. आपको tax भरना है, आपको traffic signal पे रुकना है, आपको ऐसे करना है, ऐसे करना है. Initially, जो मैं दिल में आ सकता था, मैं वो कर सकता था. But now I cannot do that. So I kind of empowered the state. ठीक है? I made some compromise on my own this liberty. I empowered them, but this now there is the duty of the state to protect my different rights, and this is what he talks about in case of social contract. That social contract happened, and as such, state came into existence. ठीक है? Then he talks about state. कि state तो बन गई social contract से. अब ये state होना कैसे चाहिए? ठीक है? That how a state should be. But you know you don't have to forget उनके दिमाग में ये चीज चल रही थी. Man by nature is evil. उन्हें लगता था कि man is not a good person, so he needs a very strict regulation by someone else. ठीक है? And as such, he advocated for a strong state. Okay? इन्हें लगता था strong state होगी, they would actually regulate people better because they are evil. वो खुद से तो regulate नहीं होंगे. वो खुद से अच्छा काम नहीं करेंगे, so as such we need a very strong state, okay? देयर शुड बी नो राइट टू रेवोल्यूशंस. स्टेट कुछ भी कहे वो लोगों को मानना चाहिए एंड पीपल शुड नॉट अपोज दैट. ओके This was his idea of state. कि social contract के बाद जो state बनेगा, this should be the ideal state. He said that state is there to safeguard the lives, because in case of state of nature, the lives of the people were not safe. So state is there to safeguard the lives of people. He advocated for a strong state. There should be no right to revolutions. This is what he said. State should have unlimited powers, and the sovereignty lies with the monarch. What is sovereignty? If you have an idea. So I have been talking about state. What is the difference between state and government? ये चीज़ तो पता होनी चाहिए. What is the difference between state and the government and sovereignty की बात. This is something very you should actually know, because we say that we the citizens of India solemnly declare to constitute India as a sovereign socialist democratic republic. The first word is sovereign, so you should be knowing. So you have an idea. मैं वो नहीं बता रहा, ठीक है, but a clear understanding of the things it should be there. अगर आप ये बताते तो मैं next question पूछता, because सुबह भी मैंने पूछा तो they had a clear understanding of what sovereignty is. So then there was my next question, but I needed first clarity on this thing. So I'm keeping it here only. So first you need to see in detail what sovereignty is. Okay. So this was his idea. State of nature. State should be like this. State is there to safeguard lives, and this was Thomas Hobbes. John Locke. He was again a 17th century English philosopher. They kind of existed at the same time. ठीक है, और इनका दोनों का नाम साथ साथ लिया जाता है. Locke and Hobbes, Hobbes and Locke. his entire theory या जो भी इनका concept था that was based on the premise that just opposed of Hobbes. Locke said that man by nature is good. ठीक है. So he also talked about state of nature and social contract, like his contemporary thinker Hobbes did. उन्होंने भी इस चीज के बारे में बात करी. He also talked about social contract. He also said roughly the same thing that initially in case of state of nature the life was not good. So people came together, they formed the state, the society came together. So there was a sort of contract. तो यहाँ पे यहाँ तक ही रफली वाज़ ऑन द सेम पेज एज वाज़ सेड बाय द हॉब्स. बट विद रेस्पेक्ट टू दिस थिंग कि स्टेट कैसी होनी चाहिए ही डिफर्ड ऑन इट. सी व्हाट ही सेड. स्टेट इज फॉर्म टू सेव गॉड following rights, life, liberty and property. If a state fails to safeguard these rights, can be thrown away. There should be right to revolutions. State fails to safeguard these rights, it can be thrown away. There should be right to revolution. Powers of state should be limited. And the last thing, so the idea of state he differed from Hobbes. This is what Locke has to say. Social contract actually differs on the idea of the state. State is formed to safeguard the following rights of life, liberty, property. If a state fails to safeguard these rights, it can be thrown away. There should be a right to revolutions. Powers of state should be limited, unlike what Hobbes said. And the sovereignty, as he said, lies with the monarch. He said sovereignty lies with the people. ठीक है. And this is an ideology or an idea he propounds in 17th century. And there is a good number of countries in contemporary world. Okay, most of the countries actually, there is a disregard for all these things. And he says ki state ko banaya gaya hai logon ne through the social contract to safeguard these rights, life ka, liberty ka, property ka. And he says in next step, if a state fails to safeguard these rights, it can be thrown away. ठीक है, then इसको बनाया गया है under contract to safeguard these rights. अगर वो कर ही नहीं पा रही है, तो then there is no purpose of having them there. But in case of contemporary world, you could see in case of different countries that there may be a right to life, but there is no regard to right to life. Same way, liberty has been trampled over again and again with respect to different people here, and with respect to property, there are issues. So the ideology that was propagated in 17th century, even we are not able to implement that properly in 21st century. उन्होंने तब कहा था मतलब वे बैक यू नो सो मेनी सेंचुरीज अगो फॉर एग्जांपल देयर मे बी एन इशू ऑफ लिंचिंग फॉर एग्जांपल ओवर देयर अ स्टेट इज नॉट एबल टू सेफगार्ड योर राइट टू लाइफ राइट ठीक है एंड द पीपल हु आर देयर दे कैन लूज द ट्रस्ट इन केस ऑफ द स्टेट एंड व्हेन द स्टेट फेल्स टू सेफगार्ड दीस राइट्स इट कैन बी थ्रोन अवे दिस इज व्हाट Locke said in 17th century. Okay, so I am telling you that this is the travesty of the times that जो उन्होंने बहुत पहले चीजें कही थी even in 21st century we are not able to live up to those expectations that the rights he propagated at that point of time. So roughly this is the difference. Both talked about social contract and the difference lies in the idea of state that he supported because his premise was man is bad, his premise was man is good. तो इनके हिसाब से कि आदमी खुद चीजें सही करेगा सो स्टेट ऑफ यू नो पावर ऑफ स्टेट शुड बी लिमिटेड ही वाज लाइक इट शुड बी अनलिमिटेड एंड दैट वाज एक्चुअली द डिफरेंस तो चीजें उस थिंकिंग से आ रही थी इनको जानते हो नेपोलियन बोनापार्ट तो यू विल रीड अबाउट दिस टू सर पढ़ाएंगे सब चीज आपको एंड नेपोलियन ने कहा था कि अगर रूसो नहीं होते तो जो इतना यू नो द मोस्ट सेलिब्रेटेड एंड डेकोरेटेड फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन व्हिच यू नो लेफ्ट इट्स लेगेसी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इक्वालिटी फ्रेटर्निटी एंड लिबर्टी दीज आर द थ्री आइडियाज दैट टॉक्ड अबाउट एंड We celebrate those ideals. So he said that if Rousseau would not have been there, there would never have been any sort of French Revolution in the first place. And this person is saying that. So that is his significance. Ke how he was strong in terms of his writings, ya jo bhi unhone kaha, as a philosopher, as a thinker. ठीक है? So to begin with, I have to talk about him. इन्होंने भी जो concept दिया वो social contract का दिया. Prior to this, we saw Locke and Hobbes, and this person refined that concept. क्योंकि ये 18th century में थे, वो 17th century में, so he actually wrote a book that was called Social Contract. It's a very famous book. तो he roughly agreed with Locke. मतलब जो उनका सोशल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट था लाइक मैन इज गुड एंड स्टेट शुड बी देयर टू सेफगार्ड द राइट्स ऑफ द पीपल इन टर्म्स ऑफ लाइफ लिबर्टी प्रॉपर्टी एंड उनके पास अनलिमिटेड पावर्स नहीं होने चाहिए लिमिटेड पावर्स चाहिए एंड सोवरेन वी शुड लाइ विद द पीपल ओके सो ही रफली एग्रीड विद द अदर्स बट ही सॉ कि एक कॉन्ट्रैक्ट हुआ था सोसाइटी में एंड स्टेट में ठीक है And kind of where this has to safeguard the rights of this, ठीक है? And they are kind of sacrificing their own liberty. But जिस time में रूसो रह रहे थे, he saw that state is actually exploiting certain sections in the society. ठीक है, exploiting certain sections. He saw that minorities are being marginalized. काम स्टेट का क्या था, सबके मतलब राइट्स सेफगार्ड करना, बट ही कुड सी ऑल दीस थिंग्स इन द सोसाइटी इन व्हिच ही लिव्ड, देयर वाज एक्सप्लॉयटेशन, देयर वाज पर्सिक्यूशन, एंड ही सेड दैट स्टेट इज नॉट यू नो डूइंग गुड फॉर एवरी सेक्शन इन द सोसाइटी. ही सॉ दिस एंड दैट्स व्हाई ही रोट इन केस ऑफ इन द सोशल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ही स्टार्टेड इट विद अ लाइन. Which again remains a very famous line. Man is born free, but he is everywhere in chains. This is how we started this his book of social contract. तो इस पे suppose मैं अभी आपसे कहूँ कि इस पे एक essay लिख लीजिए. कहीं पे देखा था मैंने. I actually checked some essay copy. तो this was the title. We'll talk about essay writing also. So not worry. So ये चीज उन्होंने देखी. He was like that because he is chains, because the state is keeping him in chains and the rights which ideally the state should safeguard, state वो नहीं कर पा रही है. तो इन्होंने कहा कि हमें इस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट को इन वे रिफाइन करना चाहिए. ये उनका एडिशनल पॉइंट था जनरल विल का, कि जब कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्चुअली बनाया जाए तो उसमें एक सेक्शन या दो सेक्शन को आपको हमें एलिनेट नहीं करना है. वी हैव टू टेक एवरीबॉडी ऑन बोर्ड एंड सोशल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट टू बी मेड टू सोशल कंसेंसस व्हाई यू टेक एवरी सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी ऑन बोर्ड, और तब जाके वो जो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट होगा दैट वुड बी सस्टेनेबल. तो तब उसमें कोई भी सेक्शन या कोई भी लोग पर्सिक्यूट नहीं होंगे. तो दिस इज हाउ वी ट्राई टू रिफाइन सोशल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, जो ऑलरेडी आइडिया दिया था हॉब्स और लॉक ने. सो दिस वाज हिज फर्स्ट आइडिया ऑफ द सोशल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. He also wrote an essay called Discourse on Origin of Inequality. So, ये भी बहुत famous है. When we talk about social stratification, the rising inequality, तो ये काफी, it is very relevant, this essay. He said that inequality is of two types in this essay. example, he said that these are the natural inequalities. इसमें इंसान का कोई रोल नहीं है. For example, you can be born as a male or a female. इसमें किसी इंसान का कुछ there is no role of any human being to play in it. You can have complexion which is either white or dark. You can, in terms of height, you can be long, you can be short or whatever. ठीक है. So these are natural inequalities and they would be there. He said the problem is with the social inequalities. What we do, he said that we convert natural inequalities into social inequalities. और ये बड़ी problem हो जाती है. For example, natural is natural. Is abhi tak ye this was natural. Sex was either male or female, but then we convert it into social, where we attach notions to both male and female. ठीक है. For example, male is someone who is physically very strong, he is very courageous, and so many things that he can do, roughly anything he can do this job. And this is not for girls. तो वो natural चीज नहीं थी. That is called in sociology gender constructionism. ठीक है. We actually formulate or associate ideas with women and men, or for example, would go for sexual division of labor. ठीक है कि ये चीज एक लड़का कर सकता है, ये चीज एक लड़की कर सकती है. तो ये जो चीज है, man and woman. I told you other day also there was one French this feminist philosopher Simone de Beauvoir, and she said that second sex. She wrote a book, and wherein she said that a woman is not born, she is created, right? तो दैट इज व्हाट शी इज बोर्न एज अ फीमेल बट देन यू अटैच नोशंस ऑफ दिस एंड दैट दैट वो ये कर सकती है शी इज बीइंग शी इज इमोशनल एंड ये हम अटैच करते हैं दिस इज नॉट समथिंग नेचुरल एंड दैट इज हाउ शी बिकम्स अ वुमन ठीक है एंड फॉर रूसो दिस इज प्रॉब्लमेटिक फॉर एग्जांपल कोई कॉम्प्लेक्शन नेचुरल ये है किसी का कॉम्प्लेक्शन या फियर है या डार्क है राइट And then society क्या करती है? They would convert it into racial prejudice. This is what society would do. And for Rousseau, that is problematic. All in all, natural inequality was not something that was problematic, but social inequality is problematic. So he wrote about this, and ये चीजें आजकल you can see that all of this is happening all the time. So that is how. And I also talked already. मैंने एक बताया था उन्होंने he wrote another book did I talk about this बताया बात की होगी मैंने बात अच्छा सुनो आपको याद आ जाएगा ठीक है as far as I told you that we are a predominantly very religious कंट्री जहाँ पे बाकी कुछ हो ना हो शाम में खाने को कुछ खाना हो बट यू हैव टू बी वेरी रिलीजियस ठीक है सो रिलीजियस इज समथिंग दैट मैटर्स टू ऑल ऑफ अस तो ही वाज लाइक दैट जब हम इनिशियली वी इन आवर फैमिलीज वी यूज सर्टेन रिलीजियस इंक्लिनेशन टू आवर चिल्ड्रन फॉर एग्जांपल एवरी चाइल्ड इज बॉर्न इन अ सर्टेन यू नो फैमिली व्हिच हैज अ सर्टेन रिलीजियस बैकग्राउंड ओके सो वो इंक्लिनेशन आ जाती है बिगिनिंग में व्हेन वी गिव देम द रिलीजियस एजुकेशन एंड देन एट द सेम टाइम देयर इज ब्रेन वॉशिंग एंड दे आर देन कीप दे आर अंडर दिस नोशन दैट आवर रिलीजन इज सुपीरियर एंड दैट इज समथिंग दैट लेटर ऑन मैनिफेस्ट्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ क्रिमिनलिज्म बिगटरी एंड फंडामेंटलिज्म एंड ऑल दोस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स सो वो एक प्रॉब्लम थी सो इन दिस बुक इमील Rousseau says that when a child is born, so immediately in few years, next few years of his birth, do not give him any religious education. Okay? So aisa karo, give him the worldly knowledge, jo bhi cheeze hoti hai, subjects, teach him all those kind of things. And over the period of time when he develops his own faculties, when he develops his own understanding, ek world mein unka ban jayega. So fir 4-5 saal ke baad you can subject him to religious education, that this is ye religion ye kehta hai, ye kehta hai, ye kehta hai, then you are at your liberty to choose one. Theek hai? So at that point of time, Rousseau says that he would have a sense about different things. Kyunki when he is absolute child, infant, and then we tell him that you belong to this religion, theek hai? And he would accept it, and at the same time we carry on brainwashing, theek hai? And even if in the long run that will not have been his choice, but kind of we force him that religion onto him, and he says that this is problematic. So ek secular society banane ke liye hame wo cheez karni chahiye, that we should not subject a child to this religious education in the beginning. We have to do that, but after some time. इसके बारे में बात की थी मैंने. ओके, मैंने बात की थी. आई नो. सो इसलिए ओके. जी एस मिल, कल भी बात की हमने इसके बारे में, हम छोड़ने वाले नहीं है, बिकॉज इज एन इंटरेस्टिंग फेलो.
Economics
theory. Well, I have to deal with it, so. He's into economics also.
Yes, there is
theory. I don't know. Maybe it would be there, so I'm not contesting that. So yesterday we talked about his idea. कल हमने बात की इसके बारे में. तो what is this qualitative utilitarianism? बताइए. Yesterday we talked about it and मुझे अपनी जगह लगता है मैं ठीक समझाता हूँ, ठीक है, बट अगर फिर भी याद नहीं आ रहा है तो देन देयर इज सम प्रॉब्लम. हाँ सही. हाँ ट्रू, वेरी गुड. सो इसके पहले बेंथम ने कहा था कि दैट प्लेजर्स आर अलाइक, देन ही मेड अ डिस्टिंक्शन दैट प्लेजर्स आर नॉट अलाइक. There can be an intellectual pleasure, there can be a sensual pleasure. You can derive pleasure from so many different things. But the quality of pleasures would be different. So this was his crux in case of utilitarianism. So that is called as qualitative utilitarianism. So we talked about that yesterday. Okay. And he was someone, he wrote a book. So we have talked about this already. He wrote a book called On Liberty, and this book mein he said, in this book liberty should be absolute unless it doesn't impinge upon the liberty of others. तब तक यू कैन अलाउ इट. So he was someone who was a very strong advocate of absolute liberty, not restricted but absolute. And he said that the only reason when state can interfere in the liberty of a person is to prevent harm to others. तब तक तो बिल्कुल state को interfere नहीं करना चाहिए unless and until my action is going to harm any other person. ठीक है? And so state cannot tell people that how many children they have to have. What to eat, which god to worship, I mean, roughly because it doesn't affect any other person. जब तक इससे किसी दूसरे को फर्क नहीं पड़ता, then state has no role to tell you that you should be doing this. So, but as of now, we see the scheme is that there our liberty remains restricted. Constitution advocates for same, ठीक है? That our liberty is restricted. There is a set of reasonable restrictions on everything. But he was someone. Who said that there should be minimum restrictions on the people? So he is someone who is being hailed as an advocate of absolute liberty. Okay, is this clear? And he is also someone Prince also advocated for absolute right to freedom of speech and expression. He believed that every narrative has an element of truth to it. If someone's right to speech and expression is curtailed, we can never have holistic decisions. We won't have every idea on board. So that won't be a holistic decision. Society may not realize the significance of an idea now and would suppress it, which however in future would be very important. Okay. So now let's talk about it. So Mills was someone who advocated for absolute right to freedom of speech. क्योंकि उनका ये मानना था कि चाहे कोई कुछ भी बोले, कितना भी बुरा बोले, ठीक है? And that may not go with the values of the society, or that may offend someone in the society. But every narrative, every statement has an element of truth to it. चाहे वो कितना ही बुरा हो, चाहे वो क्या ही चीज हो. सो इफ समवन्स राइट एंड राइट टू स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन इज कर्टेल्ड, वी कैन नेवर हैव अ होलिस्टिक डिसीजन. इज लाइक कि अगर हमें कोई डिसीजन बनाना है, इट इज बेटर कि हम इनका भी सुने, 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 सबका सुने, फिर उस सबके बेसिस पे हम कोई डिसीजन बना लें. ओके, ठीक है. बट हियर अगर ये एब्सोल्यूट है नहीं, तो परहैप्स ये तीन चार साइड्स हम मिस कर रहे हैं. ठीक है, हम सिर्फ इनको एज इनपुट ले रहे हैं, तो आवर डिसीजन वुड नॉट बी होलिस्टिक. दैट इज व्हाई ही सपोर्टेड एब्सोल्यूट राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन. एंड देन ही सेज कि अभी शायद सोसाइटी की आंखों पर पट्टी होगी किसी आइडिया को, वो बता रहे होंगे कि दिस इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, या दे वुड कर्टेल, ट्राई टू कर्टेल इट, बट लेटर ऑन इट वुड बी इम्पॉर्टेंट इन केस ऑफ फ्यूचर. For example, I gave you example of Socrates, that he supported certain ideas at that point of time. The society was not ready for those ideas. That is why he was made to drink the cup of poison at that point of time. But subsequently, we found out that had he not spoken about those ideas, so today, जो जितने भी वो values हैं, हम उनको आज celebrate नहीं करते, या हमारे पास वो values आज भी नहीं होते. So that is why he supported the idea of absolute right to freedom of speech and expression. Now the question to you is, should actually there be absolute right to speech and expression? What is the scenario as of now in case of our country? Is it absolute as of now?
No, absolute नहीं sir.
If it harms other people, it is.
Sir, emergency के time पे इसको मतलब जब कोई भी ऐसा कोई राइट होने वाला हो, उस पे फंडामेंटल राइट को उस तरह हटा दिया जाता है कि जिससे कुछ दंगे और कुछ घटना घटे, इससे एब्सोल्यूट नहीं है कोई.
अच्छा, और कुछ?
ये
विच आर्टिकल गवर्न्स राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन इन केस ऑफ अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन?
नहीं,
this is actually disappointing. If you don't know that it's Article 19, then 19. That is something that is going to boil my blood. Okay? Article 19, okay? This is something that governs right to freedom of speech and expression. Okay? So, 19 mein bahut saare parts hai. So, ye jo cheez hai, wo 19A se govern hota hai. It would also talk about right to freedom of movement, right to form of association, professional associations. तो वो आप देख लेना. ठीक है, दिस इज कंटेन्ड इन 19A. बट इन केस ऑफ 19 का पार्ट बी है, फिर देन देयर इज लाइक 1 2 3 ऐसे ही क्या कर करके, देन देयर इज पार्ट बी, एंड इन दिस पार्ट देयर इज अ सेट ऑफ 6 रीजनेबल रेस्ट्रिक्शंस. बोलना तो बोल, मतलब आप बोल लीजिए, बट सब्जेक्ट टू दीज रेस्ट्रिक्शंस, यू कैन नॉट क्रॉस ऑल दीज थिंग्स. ठीक है, एंड एज सच वी से दैट, सो वी कैन कंक्लूड दैट हमारा जो राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन, दैट इज नॉट एब्सोल्यूट. देयर आर सर्टेन रीजनेबल रेस्ट्रिक्शंस, There are even cases wherein if you cross the line, you would be subjected to punishment. For example, in the name of right to freedom of speech and expression, you can defame somebody, you can hurt the religious sentiments of any other person. You can speak certain things against the state, that is called sedition under section 124 of IPC. Criminal defamation 599 of this IPC. Again, there are so many issues, so over there we have certain restrictions that you cannot do that. And Supreme Court ne kaha tha ki you cannot crucify this somebody's dignity and reputation in the name of right to freedom of speech and expression. Ek banda hai, he has a certain reputation in the society, and I have my right to freedom of speech and expression, so main inke khilaf kuch bhi bolu. So Supreme Court over there, they admonished ki hum inka reputation mere right to freedom of speech ke liye kharab nahi kar sakte, so that is a reasonable restriction. Ya main kisi ke religion ke khilaf, I use ugly words and I make caricature of the religious symbols of any other religion, that is something that is going to be problematic. As such, we have certain reasonable restrictions. So, so there would be people, for example, Mill was there, he said that there should not be any reasonable restriction. It should be absolute. Chahe koi kuch bhi kahe, to he should be allowed to say it. But you see that in the name of... main aapse ye poochhu ki wo jo reasonable restrictions hai, whether they should be there or not. They should be there?
Yes, sir.
Kyun hone chahiye?
So they would hurt the sentiments of others in the name of freedom of speech.
Okay, they could hurt other people, so there should be those restrictions. So do you think there is a problem with the ideal of absolute right to freedom of speech and expression or with the people? You have been given this thing. For example, this. Absolute right to freedom of speech and expression. तो इस ideal में खराबी है या लोगों में?
People
should be sensible enough to follow. Okay. अरे वाह, किसने बताया? फिर तो कोई problem ही नहीं है. The society we live in, there are issues. We are a diverse country, and there would be hate mongers, with that rabid kind of thinking. They would spew venom all the time, and that would be hurting religious sentiments and other sentiments of other people. They would do defamation, etc. जैसे जैसे हम आगे बढ़ते जा रहे हैं, what we are trying to do to make it little liberal, जो भी restrictions हैं वो हम कम करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, So that people are able to speak more and more. But still there are certain restrictions which should be there so as to maintain tranquility in the society, otherwise there would be chaos. But then sometimes this question arises ki yes, right to freedom of speech and expression hona chahiye, but then there should be restrictions also. So the question arises where to draw a line. Ki kahan pe kahan tak hum allow kar sakte hain aur kahan kis cheez ke baad hum allow nahi karenge. So over there Mahatma Gandhi said that wherein this right to freedom of speech and expression can lead to violence or has a potential to cause violence, at that point of time we need to stop it. That should be the line that we can draw, and that is the doctrine that is also formed by US Supreme Court in deciding on the cases which concern the right to freedom of speech and expression. So wahan pe hame the stop karna chahiye, because otherwise there could be a huge problem. तो वो विद रिस्पेक्ट टू आइडियल वी कैन आर दिस राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन, वो चीज होनी चाहिए. बट हमारा ये सीन क्या हो गया, वी काइंड ऑफ हैव बिकम वेरी यू नो पीपल हु टुक ऑफेंस बाय एवरीथिंग. कोई कुछ इतना बोलता भी नहीं है, एंड पीपल वुड राइट सॉन्ग्स, पीपल वुड यू नो कम अप विद मूवीज, एंड नेक्स्ट डे इन दिस नेम दे वुड गो टू दिस judiciary and they will file PIL, etc. So we are becoming a society that take offense for every single thing. कोई comedian आके थोड़ा सा इधर उधर कुछ बोलता है, next day we go to police station that इन्होंने ऐसे कहा. So in that our you know that mental tolerance has come down. So we as a society need to evolve and we need not to take offense for every single thing. कि मूवी बनी सी द दिस व्हेन दिस पद्मावती मूवी वाज बीइंग मेड कि क्या हालत कर दिया ऑफ द डायरेक्टर एंड ही वाज एक्चुअली बीटन अराउंड ओवर देयर ठीक है सो उस लेवल पे हमें नहीं जाना है ही हैज हिज ओन राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन एंड ओवर देयर वी कैन नॉट से कि हम किसी ऑफ यू नो religious community ko offend kar rahe and all those kind of things because they resorted to violence and that was uncalled for at that point of time theek hai abhi wo judge karne ke liye whether movie is good whether it is sensible enough we have a censor board for that this is a country has its own institutions to decide theek hai and they had no right to take law in their own hands but nevertheless we know what happened on the sets when the movie was being made so those are problematic things which happen to we as a society also need to grow and we need not take offense for every single thing agar aapko koi movie pasand nahi hai it may hurt your sentiments so aap ye karo aap dekho hi mat what is the need to go for violence and all those kind of things so I told you ki ideal mein we can have certain restrictions but we also need to grow as a society so this was roughly about J.S. Mill. Now I'll be talking about another thinker. In the question I had UPSC mein when I wrote the mains, but I didn't know the answer at that point of time. ठीक है. बाकी सब पढ़े थे. But I miss this person, but. Was in 16, I guess this question was asked over there. लिख लिया मैंने अपने अपने मन का लिख लिया मैं ध्यान में. फिर तो यही होता है. Okay and मतलब ये ज़्यादा पुराना भी नहीं है. He died recently in year 2002. He was kind of contemporary American thinker. He is. तो इन्होंने जो भी चीजें कही या बातें कही दे रिवॉल्व अराउंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ जस्टिस एंड ही सॉ justice as a scheme of fairness treating all people equally giving same rewards for treating all people equally that would be fairness giving same rewards for same work to different people or giving same punishment for equal wrongdoing or do log they do the same crime they should receive the same punishment if there are two people who do the same good work they should receive same rewards and this is also about treating all people equally so he saw justice as fairness So to discipline justice in any society, we need to have certain principles. जस्टिस डिस्पेंस करने के लिए हर एक सोसाइटी में देयर विल बी सर्टेन प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ जस्टिस. तो ही वाज कंसर्न अबाउट कि इन्हें हम कैसे बनाएं जस्टिस प्रिंसिपल्स को. फॉर एग्जांपल ये हमारी क्लास है तो इसमें से कुछ लोगों को हम चुनते हैं इस चीज के लिए कि उनको जस्टिस प्रिंसिपल्स बनाने हैं पूरी सोसाइटी के लिए. ठीक है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एज ऑफ नाउ ही हैव टू बी द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल हिज स्टेटस इन द सोसाइटी. ओके क्या पता बन भी सकते हैं. ठीक है. तो हमारा सपोर्ट वोट जाएगा इनको. एंड सपोज इज अ सिविल सर्वेंट ही इज वर्किंग इन सम एनजीओ. दे नो देयर पोजीशन इन द स्टेट एंड स्टेटस इन द सोसाइटी एंड ऑन द बेस ऑफ देयर स्टेटस या पोजीशन दे आल्सो नो देयर फ्यूचर प्रोस्पेक्ट्स कि अगले 5 साल में ये कहाँ होंगे क्या होने वाला है. तो इनको मैं लेके आता हूँ जस्टिस प्रिंसिपल्स बनाने के लिए. तो कहीं ना कहीं दे वुड बी व्हाइल फॉर्मुलेटिंग दीज जस्टिस प्रिंसिपल्स दे वुड बी कॉन्शियस कि इन्हें सबसे ज्यादा बेनिफिट होना चाहिए इसमें. ठीक है. इट इज लाइक इट्स अ ह्यूमन टेंडेंसी दैट कम से कम अगर वो भी ना चाहे तो बट दे कैन नॉट अफोर्ड देयर ओन लॉस तो दे विल टेक केयर ऑफ दैट थिंग कि इनका कहीं नुकसान ना हो जाए जो भी जस्टिस प्रिंसिपल बन रहा है. सो ही वुड बी लाइक ही वुड यू नो propose a principle that would kind of augment the powers of the prime minister and he would do same thing for their own professions, for their own jo bhi careers hai. Theek hai. And this is something that is problematic to Rawls. He says ki is chakkar mein jo gareeb log hote hain are the marginalized section or the weaker section of the society. Unke representatives hi nahi hote hain to people don't take care of those people while making the justice principles. Theek hai. So that is why he came up with certain concepts. He came up with something called original position and wheel of ignorance. ठीक है. See what he did. अब हमें जस्टिस प्रिंसिपल्स बनाने हैं. He said कि लोगों को लेके आओ. ठीक है. But they should be या people formulating justice principles should be oblivious. मतलब उन्हें कोई जानकारी नहीं होनी चाहिए to their status in the society or what their future prospectus are going to be. This is called original position. मैं लोगों को लेके आया बट यहाँ पे सीन ये है कि आपको पहले पता ही नहीं है कि what is your status and position in the society. Society बाहर है, मैं आपको यहाँ पे लेके आया and you don't know that what's your status and position और आपको ये भी नहीं पता कि what's your future prospects. So उनको मैं यहाँ पे खड़ा कर देता हूँ और उनके सामने ये wheel of ignorance create करता हूँ. They are now ignorant. उन्हें कुछ पता नहीं. Wheel is like पर्दा. Wheel of ignorance. Now they don't know what is their status. Now they don't know that what their future prospects are going to be. और इस चीज को जहाँ पे लोगों को actually पता नहीं होता है about their status या position, that's called as original position. And he said that we have to make justice principles behind the veil of ignorance. अब ये अभी तक prime minister थे, he would try to come up with a principle जिससे इनको फायदा होने जा रहा है. ठीक है. But यहाँ पे इन्हें कोई पता नहीं है. So what, while formulating the rules, justice principles, they kind of would first assume that kya, that what if we land at the lowest hierarchy in the society? They don't know their status. So while formulating the principles, they would assume, ठीक है, कि what if we are the weakest beings in the society? So they would formulate justice principles in that way. क्योंकि किसी को पता नहीं कि मैं क्या हूँ, ना उसको अपना future prospects पता है, तो वो assume करेगा, एक suppose बाद में सोसाइटी में मुझे पता चले कि मैं सबसे गरीब हूँ, so while formulating the justice principles, ठीक है, they would take care of the weakest beings in the society, ठीक है? जो आपके प्रिंसिपल्स यहां पे बन जाएंगे दे वुड बी वेरी जस्ट एंड ह्यूमेन. एटलीस्ट इनसे फिर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन नहीं होगा, क्योंकि ये सबसे जो गरीब तबका है, पिछड़ा तबका है, उनको सोच के बनाया गया है, ठीक है, क्योंकि उन लोगों ने ये सोचा कि क्या पता हमारे हम वहीं से बिलोंग कर रहे हो, तो दे वुड बी माइंडफुल ऑफ क्रिएटिंग प्रिंसिपल्स व्हिच वुड एक्चुअली बेनिफिट दोस सेक्शंस. This is how he proposes that justice principle should be made, that while we keep people in original position and there has to be a veil of ignorance over there. बताने के बाद आप देखेंगे फॉर्मुलेट दो प्रिंसिपल्स देन यू एक्सपेक्ट टू हैव डिस्ट्रीब्यूट जस्टिस इन द सोसाइटी और समटाइम्स देयर वुड बी सर्टेन प्रॉब्लम्स इन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग जस्टिस. Justice and what is distributive justice? Any distinction you can make? Socially just distribution of goods in society. That is distributive justice. And you have to take everybody on board. And distributive justice would also mean it is not just about court kachehri. Matlab justice, jab hum sunte hai, we have that idea of justice. For example, there is poverty in the society, and there would be certain people who live below poverty line. We say that there is no economic justice in the society. If there would be caste discrimination going on, we would say that there is no social जस्टिस इन द सोसाइटी, या किसी को वोट करने दे रहे हैं किसी को नहीं करने दे रहे हैं, दैट वाज लैक ऑफ पॉलिटिकल जस्टिस इन द सोसाइटी. तो यहाँ पे डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव जस्टिस इज लाइक दैट वेयर इन वी ट्राई टू गिव दोस पॉलिटिकल सोशल एंड इकोनॉमिक जस्टिस टू ऑल द पीपल इन द सोसाइटी. वी ट्राई टू ब्रिंग इक्वालिटी ऑफ ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ, चाहे वो इकोनॉमिक हो, पॉलिटिकल या सोशल हो. That is called a distributive justice. We take everybody on board in case of distributive justice. So he talked about to solve this. सबके पास ये होना चाहिए equal liberty. You cannot allow someone to do something at the expense of other people. There should be equal liberty for all. पहले तो ये डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव जस्टिस का जो भी इशू है उसको सॉल्व करने के लिए वी हैव टू गिव इक्वल लिबर्टी टू ऑल, एंड देन अगेन देयर विल बी सम सोशल एंड इकोनॉमिक इनइक्वालिटी इन द सोसाइटी. उनको हमें ऐसे अरेंज करना है सो दैट काइंड ऑफ देयर इज वन नंबर डिफरेंशियल प्रिंसिपल. इसमें हम क्या करते हैं, balance out things. That is differential principle. For example, we intend that everybody has 100 rupees. ठीक है, मतलब यहाँ पे सबके पास 100 रुपए में चाहूँगा कि सबके पास हो. अब किसी के पास 80 रुपीस हो सकता है, किसी के पास सिर्फ 5 रुपए हो सकता है. तो differential principle के तहत मुझे जो 5 रुपए वाला है उसको ज़्यादा पैसा देना है, so as that we get equal 100 rupees. उसको मुझे ज़्यादा देना होगा, so that is called a differential principle. And then there is of course this equal opportunity principle. This doesn't need any explanation. कि सबको चाहे वो कहाँ से भी आते हैं society में, they should all get an equal opportunity. And these are the ways he roughly talked about establishing a distributive justice in the society. And that would also mean socially just distribution of goods. That would also, you know, be like social justice, political justice, economic justice, so that there is no economic disparity, there is no political or social disparity. That is distributive justice, and these are the ways he talked about in achieving that: liberty principle, differential principle, equal opportunity principle, and that is how we attain distributive justice in the society. So that was Rawls' idea of justice. और इसी पे क्वेश्चन आया था, तो ना मुझे व्हील ऑफ इग्नोरेंस पता था, ना मुझे ओरिजिनल पोजीशन पता था, ना ये प्रिंसिपल्स पता थे. ठीक है, तो आई डोंट नो फिर मैंने क्या लिखा. एंड देयर वाज, तो रहते ऐसे क्वेश्चन, बट ठीक है, नो इश्यूज विद दैट. तो मैंने आपको बता दिया है पहले. सो नाउ I don't know, we are left with some time, क्योंकि सुबह वाले session में मैंने यहाँ तक किया, and this is where we conclude our Western moral thinkers. Now we'll have to talk about Indian moral thinkers. So roughly I'll have to finish your ethics by Friday. So that is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday in 5 days, okay? So that will happen home and I'll make sure that that happens. On Saturday there would be one session on essay writing. Saturday. तो उसमें हम बात करेंगे अबाउट द ओरिएंटेशन, अबाउट द स्ट्रेटजी, आपको ऐसे चूज कैसे करना है, कैसे लिखना है, ऑल दोस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. वी विल टॉक अबाउट दैट ऑन सैटरडे. एंड ऑन संडे देयर वुड बी अ कंबाइंड सेशन, प्रोलॉन्ग्ड सेशन, ठीक है. उसमें वी विल टेक रफली आई थिंक 4 essays, ठीक है. एंड वी विल एक्चुअली टॉक अबाउट देम, डिस्कस देम, विल ट्राई टू राइट देम. कि दैट वुड बी काइंड ऑफ अ वर्कशॉप, ठीक है. So that you get actually the practice ki likhna mujhe kaise hai, kyunki usse pehle main discuss karunga ki strategy kaise honi chahiye, kaise aapko jana hai, fir unhi cheezon ko hum implement karne ki koshish karenge. We will use like 4, 5, maybe even 5 of these essays, theek hai, which have been asked actually by UPSC. So we'll try to discuss ki inme kya likhna hai, kaise likhna hai, so that you have that understanding in the first place, theek hai. And then maybe on Monday you'll have a test on essay itself. क्योंकि मैंने सुबह वाले में नहीं पढ़ाया इंडियन वाला, बट ठीक है. एक वो क्वेश्चन था इनका, आई ट्राई टू रीड दैट आउट बिकॉज आई फाउंड आउट दैट इट इज देयर इन द पेपर. सो फिर इसके बाद हम आई लीव यू, कल आपकी छुट्टी है, सो यू कैन एंजॉय दैट. हाँ कल की क्लास ही है.
सर टेस्ट में सर प्लीज प्रोडक्ट टाइप.
अरे मैंने आप आज
देखा. मुझे भी तो छुट्टी चाहिए ना. Okay, if you have actually mobile with you and you can see it, so you can, I'll read it out. That is question number 11. Agar aapke saath hai nahi to main waise bhi padhunga, you'll anyway get to know okay, what's written over there. Theek hai, question number 11, you can see that. You're there? Okay. The question is, undercover journalism exposes injustices, negligence, corruption and wrongdoing, and yet going undercover to expose wrongdoing remains controversial. But undercover journalists contend that they are fulfilling a fundamental duty of finding truth through their journalism. They argue that public enlightenment is the forerunner of justice and the foundation of democracy, and duty of the journalist is to further those ends by seeking truth and providing a fair and comprehensive account of events and issues. So there are some supporters of this kind of journalism which sometimes infringe the privacy of individuals. However, some journalists also urge avoiding super surreptitious methods of gathering information, except when traditional open methods will not yield information vital to the public. In this context, answer the following questions. And the part one is, what are the ethical issues involved in practice of undercover journalism? That's part one. Number two is, do you support the practice of undercover undercover investigation by journalists? Give reasons in support of your answer. Okay, so I write that undercover journalism is hailed by some as act of valor and denounced by some as infringement of rights. While the debate is on, various ethical issues are. Okay, so here we try to address the first part of the question. It is number one is like infringing the right of privacy. That would be the ethical issue. Observer dropping and snooping is against the constitutional rights. Observer dropping is like overhearing something. कोई बात कर रहा है अंदर से, मैं बाहर से कान लगा रहा हूँ, so that kind of thing. Number three, that it undermines one's right of dignity. Okay, because privacy is associated with dignity. Number four, to unearth one case of wrongdoing, hundreds of people are subject to surveillance, right? Number five, it is often motivated aim to defame a person. ठीक है, ये चीज भी है. Number six, you can see there is diversity. I'm not explaining the things. ठीक है, तो एक लाइन में you can write six is vested interests play important role. in case of, because they remain very motivated. Number 7, there is no standard operating procedure for undercover journalism. तो आप जैसे चाहो कैसे कर सकते हो, that's an ethical issue. Number 8, it undermines the space of people and this can lead to disillusionment with the state. Okay, these are certain ethical issues. Then coming to the part 2, and I'm trying to answer to that part, and I'm writing, undercover investigation exposes injustices, negligence, corruption and wrongdoings. For example, investigative journalism of Aaj Tak revealed leakages in the PDS. Okay? And Tehalka, this was a magazine, brought many sensational issues to fore by investigative journalism only. Tehalka was famous only for their investigative journalism. So there is a case for allowing undercover journalism or investigation. उन्होंने पूछा था whether you support it or not. ठीक है? But the following precautions are needed. ठीक है? Number 1, the investigation must not be motivated for vested interests. Okay? Number 2, journalists who carry it must be of high credibility. कोई भी सड़क छाप ये नहीं करना चाहिए. Number 3, if an evidence is unearthed, it must be given to police rather than broadcasting. Okay? Police can do subsequent investigation after taking the leads of the media. Number 4, there should be courses of investigative journalism, so standards of journalism are not compromised. Number 5, there are cases where journalists misrepresent facts, statements to corroborate their own narratives. This has to stop. Okay? Number 6, after investigative journalism, if there has been malicious intent, the journalist needs to be punished. Okay? And number 7, media should stop passing on judgments. And once investigation is done, it must be passed on to the police and allow law to take its own course. This is something that how you write in very short points. You add diversity. आप यू नो यहाँ वहाँ का एक्सप्लेनेशन की जरूरत नहीं है. अगर आपके पास एग्जाम्पल है यू गिव दैट, अगर नहीं है तो मत दीजिए. बट यू ऐड डाइवर्सिटी एंड यू डोंट काइंड ऑफ बीट अराउंड द बुश. जो पूछा है वही एट मैक्सिमम आई डिवोटेड टू लाइंस इन इंट्रोडक्शन, यू कुड सी दैट, एंड फिर यू कम टू द जो भी रिक्वायरमेंट है. ठीक है? एंड देन जितने भी पार्ट्स होंगे क्वेश्चन के उन पर बात करनी है. सो दैट इज हाउ इट विल डेवलप इन यू. तो ऐसे ही लिखना है. बाकी you don't have to be certain, you know, geniuses or experts or research scholars that you will write in detail. Uski zarurat nahi hai. Aap agar koi essay is pe likhna hai, then certainly you have to write things in detail. Ya ek hi point ko utha ke aap pura ek page likh sakte ho, but that is not required. Jitni diversity hogi, utne aapko number milte hain. Visibility honi chahiye, ki dikhna chahiye. I told you ki jitne main tick marunga aapke paper mein, utne number zyada aate hain. So scope होना चाहिए वो टिक लगाने का मुझे. ठीक है? So that way you can actually improve. So there are some other questions also you can check out on those to have the preliminary idea. I'm not saying that these are model answers, so I wrote them in classroom only in that limited 3 hours. But ठीक है? But still मतलब ठीक है, and you can actually have an idea to begin with. तो later on आप इससे भी अच्छा लिख सकते हो, उसमें कोई issue नहीं है. ठीक है? So that's up to you. You have to improve on that count. Okay. Okay. Taking a leave. Have a very happy weekend. Enjoy the holiday. And kal mujhse nijaat mil jayegi, so enjoy.
छोड़ा यार आज.